I was 28 years old. I was in a movie called Hollywood and Wine. I was a Playboy model. I did Millionaire Matchmaker. I did Farmer Wants a Wife. I remember it was October of 2010. And it was Friday night, and I don't know what happened, but like I crashed and burned. I wasn't getting invited to any celebrity events anymore.
So this was before Dr. Phil?
Yeah, this was before right. Dr. Phil. I posed for Playboy. I got a little bit of celebrityism. I was sitting in my apartment. It was Friday night, and I was just laying in bed, and I felt empty. And I remembered that, you know, that these kind of times in my life where I felt like emptiness, there were always times that I received like a message from God. And I remember it was like Friday night. It was about 7:30 at night. And I get a phone call from a casting producer over at Dr. Phil. Her name was Kia. And she said, "Hi, my name is Kia. I was referred to you by this casting director that put you on Millionaire Matchmaker. We're doing a show called Spoiled and Entitled. And there's a girl named Erica from The Bachelor. And we would like to know, like, how spoiled and entitled are you?" And Greta, I remember that at that point, Brett Ratner told me I was fat. He laughed at me, and I asked him to shoot me for the cover of Playboy, and he told me that Playboy was beneath me and him, and that he shoots only campaigns for like Jimmy Choo and, you know, Baby Fat and Mariah Carey, and that I just need to like stop looking for the easy way out. And then I find out, you know, that he has a girlfriend who's a supermodel who's not really like sexy. She's more of like she's been in Victoria's Secrets and Vogue and Elle. She's like one of those supermodels. And he shot her for the cover and
of Playboy.
And I was just like mortified. And he told me, he's like, "Look, this is what you have to look like to be in Playboy." I felt in my head that he wanted me to be on zero, so whenever he called, I would go running. And my goal always was, like, when I turned 24 and I posed for Playboy, I liked having a little bit of that celebrityism, because I feel like when women are successful, you have more power and you have more of a control. So when he did this thing with Playboy, I was so hurt. Because I couldn't believe it. I mean, it's not
he's told you one thing and he's done the exact opposite.
He stole my idea from me. And when he texted me that he was shooting her cover, I started like crying. I couldn't stop for like 13 hours, but I felt like I was dying. I was so angry. I was so broken. I felt like somebody just killed me, buried me, spit on me. And it just, I was mortified. So I started crying and screaming. And when I get really angry, I calm down and then I get vindictive. And that's something I have to work out with a therapist. When I was younger, I used to get vindictive. Not like against the law, but like I think, okay, well, I'm going to show this. I call him a shtimp. He was 5'8", 5'9". He was a little shtimp. You know, I said, "I'm going to teach this shtimp a lesson." So I called over to Playboy and I asked to speak to the manager and Hefner in the marketing. And I started crying. I said, "Please don't publish this cover." I said, "That was supposed to be me. And I'm one of your models." So you know what Playboy did, Greta? They pulled the cover and they put Marge Simpson on the cover like a character, and they gave him the alternative cover. So I texted him back. And I said, "Ha, ha, ha." He flipped out. He called the rabbi that introduced us. And then he called me crying. And he's like, "Well, would you like to meet and talk?" I said, "No, Brett." I said, "I might have loved you. I might have wanted to be with you. But you know what?" I said, "If God can give me a little bit of success, I don't need a short motherfucker like yourself." And so because of Brett, kind of, I created Spoiled and Entitled. And so that was the first time that God blessed me and showed me some, not revenge, but like for me, like if he would have got the main cover of with this model, I mean, I would have been crying and miserable. But it helped, the fact that Marge Simpson graced the cover.
Fail with Greta Lee Jackson is presented by me. Recorded at the studios of Podcast One Australia. For more episodes, head to podcastone.com.au, download the Podcast One app, or look me up on iTunes.